This is Bob Kraft from Hong Kong, China, and I'm excited to be here to talk to you about the Australian Open. We're into the final days. It's January 26th. We're coming into the semifinals, and some of them are already in the finals, so we're going to talk a little bit about the mixed doubles, tell you how this ministry's been able to help some of the players, and also help you to understand a little bit more about how it works and how it can help you and the players you work with. We have already one of the finalists determined, which is Azarenka and Kirilenko. Azarenka is from Belarus and Kirilenko is from Russia. I knew Victoria Azarenko before when she was a junior, and her mother, I've sat with her mother at the French Open, and very nice woman, very kind person. Her coach at that time I knew, and he was very supportive of me. I did find out that they are Christians as far as going to church. I don't know how much, you know, that involves their personal life as far as their inner life, but for sure that's part of their background. And my role is to kind of encourage them in that, not let them forget it, which is so easy to do on the pro tennis tour. And then at the same time to try to give them more and more information, which will help them. So that's one team. And then the other semifinals, which is being played right now as I tape this, is Doko and Panada versus Liesl Huber and Nadia Petrova. So we don't know who's in the final. We don't know who's going to win that match. But I do want to talk a little bit about the Liesl Huber and Petrova. Liesl's been given a Christian testimony on the tour. She's actually had something printed in the WTA newsletter about her Christian faith. You know, she's been very open about it, and I've spent time with her and her husband a lot of time sitting down with them. It plays a big role in her life, but I think there's always a little bit of a between the tennis court and the Christian life, and I'd like to see that more, where she takes that in onto the tennis court and around the tennis environment. But I admire her a lot, and I think she's going to turn out really well as far as she's had a great career. And I think she's going to have a great future. She's been with her husband a number of years now, Tony Huber, down in Houston, Texas. And it's been a joy to get to know them. And she's always been someone who's been kind to me, so I appreciate that. And then we have Nadia Petrova. Many of you know her from her singles days. Her ranking is, I think her highest has been around number 5 in singles. She came up to me last year. I've been giving her and her coach material for about 5 or 6 years. And her coach came up to me at Wimbledon a few years ago and said, the material you give me, which is the daily verse, we use it. Now, she wasn't working with that coach recently. He's moved on. He actually works with top players, like number one players. But I think she never forgot that. So she came up to me last year. I ran into her at Wimbledon in the Starbucks, and I gave her some material in Russian. And then when I saw her last year at the Australian, she said, I want you to come and work with me. So I spent a lot of time with her. We do it off the court. We do Bible studies. I tell her about faith. I tell her how that applies to her tennis matches and how she can control her emotions, because she's had problems with that area of her tennis playing, and how that all fits in with God gives you stability, basically, and happiness and joy and not anger, at the wrong kind of anger. So we spent a lot of time talking about that, and I was really glad. I was sitting in her box when she beat Kim Clijsters last year, when she beat Svetlana. I was there, and then also when she played Justine, and she just lost by a couple points on that match. So those are players that doubles players that have meant a lot to me, and I'm just going to be around and be stable. And hopefully that's what they'll remember me for, is that I was able to be around for a number of years and I never changed what I said or thought. And so it's been a joy. I think the women's doubles is always fun to watch, and it's going to be exciting to see, if you've got cable there in your country where you can watch some Australian Open. It's always some in the U.S. you're getting in the middle of the night. But please do watch it, and at the same time pray for the players, especially now that you know a little bit more about where they're from and what their background is, what they believe. And look forward to seeing you again. If you need to contact me, you can do so at kraft@tennisministry.org. Thanks a lot. Have a good day.